Viewers, I am A.K. Singh, Department of Zoology, Banaras Hindu University. I am going to explain heterozygosity in a population. In fact, in a population, two different kinds of individuals could be present with respect to a single gene locus, that is homozygotes and heterozygotes. So if we consider a particular locus, like suppose this is the locus where a specific gene is located. That could be protein coding gene. Now this locus, if it is represented by two alleles, that is capital A and small a, these are two alleles which may be present on this locus. So due to these two alleles, three genotypes will be possible. Capital AA, capital A small a, and small a, small a. These three genotypes will be there, but these capital AA and small a, they are homozygotes. Now heterozygotes, they will have both alleles, that is the dominant one or recessive one, or these two alleles may be co-dominant even. They could be incomplete, you know, show dominance. So such kind of things may be there, but heterozygotes will definitely be present in the population if it is a large and randomly mating population. But the frequency of these heterozygotes will depend on the number of individuals present in the population. If a population is very large one, then we expect quite good number of heterozygotes in the population. And if a population is very small, then definitely the number of homozygotes will be more. And that will be because of inbreeding. So, how the number of individuals influences heterozygosity in a population, that we can understand, that we can calculate. So, let me take certain example, and on the basis of that, we will see that how the number of individuals present in a population influence the heterozygosity. We can measure this heterozygosity by using the formula, that is H T equal to 1 minus 1 divided by 2 N E to the power small t into H O. This is a simple formula. By using it, we can measure heterozygosity, where this H T stands for heterozygosity in generation T. T refers number of generations. Then 2NE, this 2NE, it represents, in fact, NE is number of effective population size, or effective population size. This indicates 2 into effective population size. What is effective population size? Effective population size refers to the number of reproductively mature individuals who are contributing to the next generation. So, all those individuals, males and females, in a sexually reproducing population, which are involved in reproduction and produce progeny for the next generation, are considered to make effective population size. So whatever their number is, that number will be multiplied with 2. Then this HO stands for the initial heterozygosity. HO indicates initial heterozygosity. What was heterozygosity in the population in the initial stage? So by using this formula, we can see that if effective population size is very large, then what could be the situation? And if effective population size is very small, then what will be the situation? So just by considering the number of individuals who are contributing to the next generation, we can know the fate of heterozygosity. Let us consider a particular case, one case in which this HT, that is, we want to see heterozygosity in next generation, in generation 1. And here this NE, that is effective population size, that is 10. 10 individuals are there which make the effective population size. We can consider at the initial population heterozygosity is suppose 0.5. This is one case we are going to take, that is, only 10 individuals are present in a population. Definitely it is a very small population and it will influence heterozygosity, because I just told you that in a small number of individuals the chances of inbreeding will be high. We can consider another situation when the heterozygosity will be measured in the next generation, that is, first generation. First generation means just next generation, and we will see that if NE is equal to 1000 and if this initial heterozygosity is equal to 0.5. So I am going to take two separate cases to measure it. Now we will see this HT, that is, heterozygosity in first generation, that will be equal to 1 minus 1 by 10 into 2, that is 2NE, to the power 1, that is, in the next generation, into 0.5. So when you will measure this, you will find the value coming as 0.475. You will get this value, 0.475. When you will solve it, this particular value will come. Now if we consider the same situation, that is, heterozygosity in the first generation, when number of individuals are quite large or more in number, that is, 1 by suppose 1000 individuals are there, and we want to test it in the next generation, initial frequency is 0.5, then in that case, when you will solve this, it will come 0.499. So what we are observing, that is, when the number of individuals are very less, there is much influence on the heterozygosity. Heterozygosity has gone down from 0.5 to 0.475. There is considerable decrease in the heterozygosity. It's happening only because less number of individuals are there and close matings will be there, mating between close relatives will be there, and that will result into more homozygosity. Whereas if number of individuals are more in the population, then you will find that there is very subtle, very little change in the frequency of heterozygosity. It has gone 0.5 to just 0.499, means very negligible change is there. Same thing we can study by considering fifth generation. What would be the change in fifth generation? So if we want to see that if similar conditions prevail, and we have to see that what is happening in the fifth generation. Now initially the frequency of heterozygotes, that is 0.5, 10 number of individuals are there, and we are going to study this heterozygosity in fifth generation. So this will be power 5. This will be power 5. We are going to study it in the fifth generation. Heterozygosity in the fifth generation, number of individuals in every generation is almost 10, means very few individuals are there. So an initial frequency is 0.5. Then when you will calculate, when we will calculate this, we will be finding a different, you know, figure. It will come, when you will calculate, this will come 0.387. Whereas in this case, it will come 0.4. 4, 9, 8. Again, see, we are observing that very drastic change has occurred in the number of heterozygotes in the fifth generation, because in every generation some homozygous matings will be there. Heterozygosity, if mating between heterozygotes take place, then homozygotes will also be formed. They will get added with the homozygotes, and ultimately the frequency, which was 0.5, that has come to 0.387. Here it is 0.5 in the initial stage, but it has gone very little, means decrease. It is 0.498, almost similar to the initial stage. So this indicates that when there is larger number of individuals present in a population, then that is going to influence heterozygosity to a very subtle level. Whereas if very less number of individuals are there, then there will be higher chances of inbreeding, and that will result into reduction in heterozygosity. So heterozygosity, that gets highly influenced by the presence of number of individuals, particularly those individuals which are participating in, maybe that sometimes the population looks very large, but that population may have only few individuals who are actually contributing to the next generation, because in that large population there could be very young individuals who are immature, who are not contributing for the next generation. There may be so many old people or old individuals who are actually they have lost their reproductive ability. So sometimes a population may be looking as very large, but in reality that population may be quite small, because the number of individuals participating in reproduction may be very less in number. So all these factors actually influence the heterozygosity. I hope that this will help you to understand that how does effective population size influence heterozygosity in the population. Thank you.